Breaking out of smallness into greatness. Breaking out of smallness into greatness. That is. Can you tell Jesse how we are needed? To break, what does it mean? Iba wapo, iba kapota, ni pempe, weba yeni duku, iba kapo, iba kapota. To break out. For every breakthrough to occur, something must break. Breaking out of smallness into greatness. Quickly, before we pray. Point number one. Greatness is yours by inheritance. There's no time enough to do a recap of the first service. But suffice it that this subject matter is also dealt with in part in the first service. Greatness is yours by divine inheritance. Idiuku bibe chukunye gogi site na omumu amoge ebo nwachi. I could have first service see you now more mad ubolona bo. Every child of God, I'm okay ubolone. Ubole bo, ubole sato. Makanu ne mere incarnation. Praise God. Ubole bo. I hope you know that reincarnation is a doctrine of the devil. Reincarnation. Where you ready? In no wa. No nye no lo nye wa. It's a demonic thing. Even with the same spirit, familiar spirit he possesses. But somebody has said, excuse me, sir. Hey, but even in a village, I'm more the child. The other one will have been born in your chili mark in Aro, in King Carmel, Bukwele, the same mark of Patan. No, 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 familiar spirits are now come. And reproduce this, those same marks on the body of the baby. When a genie may have for woman wise, this figure, you all say in the womb, how much more in your mark in one black one before. So they keep deceiving people. It is not the same person that came back, it is the same demon that came back. Praise God. It's the same spirit of reincarnation. When we were growing up, we saw a lot of things, a lot of drama. A little child of 7 years. One kuive papi amaro, papi adjuese obulezi oku. Ona si mbe nyamuro enikweli na palo. Praise God. And really, the grandfather requested that he be buried in a palo. But ebe kwenzo na wemo mwe yeye. Was in the same virgin alpha, the same man reincarnated into so many people. Praise God. I say no, yano lonyo wa, no nyo wa, no nyo wa, no. Obu no the same spirit, obu the same spirit of ufonyawa ga abachana man. It can only be in one place at a time. The Bible says it's appointed unto man once to die, and after death, judgment. All the demons, familiar spirits. That the person served by each and now control it. That's why when you become a Christian, you need to fight those spirits. Whether you know it or not, somebody, they claim that somebody reincarnated you. Because the familiar spirit that followed that person has been following you before you got born again. So when you get born again, you arrest the demon. False prophet, like this, false prophet, and the spirit, and carry. By the other spirit, he false prophet, he will not be able to see anything. Praise God. Your history, he followed your grandfather, he followed your father. So when you stand there, the false prophet, the spirit about you. In it, hey, who is a Caressa? Who is Jacinta? That's my sister. Who is Somto? Hey, that's my brother. Wobbish. Wobbish. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. My second son, Mopelope, even worrying, he was a wobbish when he was small. Praise God. Now, we have dual inheritance. The natural man and the spiritual man. The natural man was born first, and the spiritual man was born second. The Bible exemplified it through Adam that was born first, and then Jesus, the spiritual man. Every man that is born again is born twice. You were born by your parents, so you inherited some things from them. Then you were born by God. You inherited some things from God. So the whole subject of spiritual growth is a fight between natural inheritance and divine inheritance. You want to use your divine inheritance to kill natural inheritance. That is the journey of the children of Israel to the Canaan land is a typology of the journey of a Christian into the promises of God. Everything that God promised you, they symbolize, they come together to make up your spiritual personality, who God wants you to be. And God said, the children of Israel, this land of Canaan is yours by divine inheritance. But there were people that already inherited that land naturally. And the battle of Canaan was the battle between divine inheritance and natural inheritance. Israel wetediana by divine inheritance. The Canaanites wetelie by natural inheritance. So divine inheritance na natural inheritance clash, yeah? Divine inheritance prevail. Yeah? That is the whole subject of Christianity. Imeli woko inherit naturally. But we have the fruit of the Spirit, which you inherited from Christ, which includes patience, meekness, and you have to use it to kill the woko imeli inherit naturally. You have inherited the fruitfulness from God. Like we read in Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3, that God has blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. So one aspect of that inheritance of who we are, which the enemy is contesting, that we want to discuss in this service, is greatness. Somebody say, I am destined for greatness. I am great by the gift of God, by divine inheritance. Greatness is inside me. I am not wishing to be great. I am already great by divine inheritance. Amen. Excuse me. The child of an elephant, don't look down on it. Don't use his present size to judge him. Because there is something in him that will make him bigger than two cows put together. It's only a question of time. Let one nigga can see an order inside you. Greatness, order inside you. Order inside you. 1 John 4 verse 4. He says, fear not, for you have overcome them. Ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. For greater, somebody shout, greater is he that is inside Pastor Wisdom than all the nyama forces that are opposing me. Praise God. That is, before the battle started, you already won. Because a heavyweight champion was fighting with a boy of 10 years. The Bible said that what is inside you is already greater than any opposition that you will ever meet. That is your takeoff point. It's already a deficit for the enemy. Praise God. Ye have God. Ye are of. That ye of God, though, just for nothing. Ye are of God. Little. They may look at you at your present size. They may look at your present income. But what they didn't see is that you are of God. What they didn't see is the divine connection. What they didn't see is the greater one inside you. I decree they shall bow. They shall bow. They shall bow. The important point there is ye are of God. He didn't say adult men. He said little children. Why did he say little children? You may look down on yourself. Others may look down on you. They may not think that you are somebody important or that you will become somebody important tomorrow. But the dividing line, the factor that decides is that what? Ye are of God. Excuse me. The child of an elephant does not pray to become big. It's not a prayer point. What he just needs is the right atmosphere, nourishment, everything. It's already inside him. What does it mean to be a child of God? The child of God means that what is inside God is inside you. If a goat gives birth in your village and that goat looks like a cat, there will be confusion in the village. I got back up. A woman, a wolf tells a woman, I will pussy. The pussy netto. I saw Gatana village. Ukata won't get him one. Okay, Yinketa. I told him one will. Excuse me, in the choir. If you want, can you go horse? Chuku mwonga kedivo geyi. He said, I have said ye are gods and all of you children of the Most High. He said, but they will die like one of the four princes and they will die like men and fall like one of the princes. Why? Because they didn't know. They know not, neither do they understand. All the foundations of the earth are out of course. When people don't understand their identity, they live below what God has made them to be. Praise God. Nwa governor batana gate government house. Because man na either no matter na yabo nwa governor or no mental problem. Praise God. Your divine identity, understanding of who you are, plays a crucial role to your success. One group said, we be not able to enter the promised land. I think that's Numbers chapter 13. Look for the verse, Numbers 13. They said, we be not able. But Joshua and Caleb said, we are well able. And because they said they are well able, they were able to enter. Praise God. Because they understood who they are. The dividing line is ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. Why did you overcome them? Because the person inside you is already bigger. We illustrated it. Hello, sir, please come. Two boys. Come. Yes. Bobo. Come. Yes, you come. No, not you. Hey, girl, young girl. Oh yeah, come. Good. These two. Stand this behind this one. These two are fighting. Okay, no. You go here. This one is big. So these two are fighting. This is the one backing this person up. And is fighting face each other. And they're about to fight. Stay behind. This is the one that is backing him up. The Bible says, ye are of God, little children, and have overcome them. Before the battle started, you already overcame them. Why? Because greater. Hello, sir. Back. Stand behind this one. This one is backing this one now. And battle will ensue. Do you need anybody to tell you who will win the battle? Yeah. One blow from here, two of them will be lying on the ground. Put your hands together for Jesus. He said, you don't need any prophet. Before the battle started, you won. And the reason is that the person who is backing you is greater than all the people backing you. I decree that in the name of Jesus Christ, every witchcraft gang up, every occultic gang up, every satanic conspiracy against you, they are crushed. They are crushed by the reason of the Almighty God that is backing you. They are crushed. Can I hear that amen three times? Yes. Hallelujah. In Luke chapter 17, verse 20, the Bible says the kingdom of God cometh not by observation. Luke 17, verse 20. Neither do they say, lo, it is here, or lo, it is there. But where is the kingdom of God? Can I hear somebody speak? Where is the kingdom of God? Inside who? Inside Pastor Wisdom. Praise God. Neither shall they say, lo here or lo there. Behold, the kingdom of God is where? Yeah. Now, let me tell you something about that kingdom of God in Matthew chapter 13, verse 31. Matthew 13, verse 31. The Bible says that kingdom of God is like a mustard seed. Smallest of all the seeds. But when it grows, somebody say when it grows, it becomes a giant herb. Which indeed is the least of all the seeds, but when it's grown, it is the greatest among the herbs, and becometh a tree, so that the birds of the air can wagon. Ogi can in a jelly and your family. And the guy, people are not. More sooner, a family, I'm not giving it. Not that family. Because you accepted Christ. Oboro by accident, kids are born again. Oh, my, more soon, the deep and in and down, listening in. Mana umu Israel amara na Jesus was son of God. Mana ndi mojo mala. OJM administration, we know who you are. You are the son of God. Shut up. The Pharisees are saying, what David? People make a maro. Don't blame them. Manogi kachuku meleze na that family. Change the fortunes of that family. And it will come to pass before our very eyes. In the name of Jesus Christ. So they may see you physically. But the Bible said when it is grown, or just a little time. Every position has opposition. You are praying for greatness, Abby, that it will manifest. Every level has a devil. And every position has opposition. That is why you need power. David was anointed king. I saw Sunday no. All the genuine prophets of God, man, David Beze. Man, a physical, natural man. I'm not no Eze. Oh, Sunday number, it is a man. Man. Come on, one thing we found out. Later, but no one stand against the throne of David, lost his head physically. Physically. Undinine stand against the throne of David, they lost their head physically. And when they are at war to fight Israel, or you know, different wars, he was engaged in, but that's not what I'm talking about. They be to collect his throne from him, they lost their head. Praise God. The first person was who? Goliath of Gath. The Bible said David killed him and cut off his head. The second person was who? King Saul. He was killed. The Philistines collected his head and put it in their temple. The third person that came, because Goliath of Gath, he got told what? Why he was challenging the throne of David? Chineke anoint go David, not in that cheese. Goliath is open a million unu and chiba unu. Open on a chi. Kerebebe David the gatches. So it's an attempt against his throne, and the man's head was removed from his body. Obro just nebuliebu, the head left the body to be that he died dead. Praise God. The same thing with King Saul. Another person was Ish-bosheth, the son of Saul. When Saul died, General Abner took Ish-bosheth, Nwa Saul. Many years now, come on, David Gach. Nyachiba. People in his house conspired and cut off his head. Palisye Patal David. Another person that attempted against the throne of David was Sheba, the son of Bichri. He blew a trumpet and said, oh, to your tents, O Israel. And some people gathered to him. Joab and Ami, Chubia, Obaba and a 145 city. Joab were decided, and Agamu here the city, Oko, the stronghold, together with Indinonia. One woman were put out. Say, Joab, can you be chosen by Ochepo, Ndin Kechineke? Somebody had to have Ochepo, Ndin Kechineke. No one man, Sheba, the Mwabichiri, no one read to like himself against the throne of David. Or say, I challenge. Now, I guess in a wall or two, a telegis here. The woman just discussed what within the okay, or this man would be enough to kill all of us. All of us will die. Can you not believe the man, a GD, Yabu Fiesi, Sina, now war, two begis here, Joab Nene, Obelisia, over trumpet, so you have another. Praise God. The fifth person, Bo Absalom. Also, na David, Belle, Wam, Wamo, Wam Absalom. Is here where Colonel. Not just because of Ebele David, or Kadapo Adapo. Stand to your feet. Say in the name of Jesus, I am destined to rule, and any power, any agent of Satan opposing my destiny in my family, in my kindred, oh Lord, cut off their heads. Sword of the Lord, cut off their heads. Eleko shakata legadea katash. La prakoto se katale katala gadash. Leke prekete se katale kapra. Sword of the Lord, cut off their heads. Cut off their heads. Cut mebu bisi, mebu bisi. Cut off their heads. Jesus said, all those that say I will not rule over them, bring them and kill them. That was the most violent word we saw from the mouth of Jesus, because some people we are fighting his throne. Cut off the head of that witch. Cut off the head of that wizard. Sword of the Lord. Cut off their heads. Cut off their heads. Cut off their heads. Your throne is the seat of your greatness. As long as David did not sit on that throne, even Chineke deli David aputarife. Bible ekugo na Jesus will sit on the throne of David mogabia. But David had to have a throne. Every child of God is a king. Any king without a throne is not yet full. Any power contesting my throne, let your head be cut off. Oh, Gika Chuku Melez and another family. Gika Chuku Menikachi. Gika Chuku Gajis of Tandozo. Gika Chuku Gajin Nelendozaka. He gave me a scholarship. He got loan some people on. He gave send some people over the boy. Equal Somalia. When I bag him back. One Yobana, one Kobana. He called Chobana. Baba Lawa, Mama Lawa, Auntie Lawa, Uncle Lawa, Sister Lawa, Brother Lawa. Let God cut off their head. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. You may be seated on the head of your enemy. Point number two. Anytime you move to enter greater levels, God will not say no. Anytime you take a decision, anytime it enters your mind, anytime you move to enter greater levels, God will not say no. Anytime you move to enter greater levels, God will not say no. In the place where we read in 2 Kings chapter 6, verse 1, and the sons of the prophet said unto Elisha, behold now, the place where we dwell with thee is too narrow for us. Let us go, we pray thee, unto Jordan, and take thence every man a beam, and let us make us a place there where we may dwell. And what did he answer? Don't go. He said, go ye. Anytime you make an attempt to enlarge your business, God is happy. Anytime you make an attempt to enlarge your coast, God is happy. The Bible said Jabez saw what was happening in his family. Everybody was ending up in smallness. And one day Jabez woke up. He said, excuse me, what? I saw it in my father. I saw it in my grandfather. I even heard it happen to my great grandfather. I am not going to end the same way. Oh Lord, that thou will enlarge my coast. And the Bible said God granted his request. Anything that kept others down in smallness in that family, today anabadie in your life. Anabadie in your life. Enwe family ebe ba da mutanwa. Enwe family ebe ba da patego. Enwe family ebe enwere onye powerful ego. Where you can't see 1 billionaire in that family. His strength is of the devil. And yet, one of the funniest things is that if there is somebody who is a half millionaire in that family, he will be thinking himself rich. Unanya ndozo na anya bicycle, nyawa na anya old model, fourth hand car. Osini ade rich, manachuku deli ekobule billionaire. It will never happen to you. One of the problems of people, especially around this area, is early arrival syndrome. Early contentment. Early arrival. Every day I cry, Lord, expand this church. Enlarge this church. And one pastor, one bishop, said to me, you need to be made bishop. Look at the kind of thing that God is using you to do. I say, excuse me. So, Bishop Kita now, at this level, can even make a achievement in Jigabu Bishop? Praise God. How do you know 75 years? Where will Bishop? Praise God. Early arrival syndrome. Put some pastors in this church now. And that is all their wish. But God is witness, every day I shed tears. I say, God, we can't end here. Multitudes are still dying and going to hell. My prayer for you is that you will have hunger, that greatness God put inside you will manifest. Hunger. The greatest key of success is hunger. Hunger. Anytime you move to enter greater levels, God will not say no. Did you know that Elisha was with them in that house? He said, verse 1, and the sons of the prophet said unto Elisha, behold now, the place where we dwell with thee is too small. You think Elisha didn't know? They were living with Elisha inside one room. Maybe about 6 of them. Elisha, Baba and Kitty. I'm already a national prophet. I'm gradually about to finish what I came to do. One day, all is too small. Elisha said, okay. Praise God. They say we want to go and cut beams. Can you go with us, sir? He said, I'll go. Praise God. Oh God, are you not seeing my situation? God is seeing it. Oh, Chineke, hopefully I did before. It is you that will decide to move. It is you that will decide enough is enough. There must be a change. God saw their situation. The prophet saw their situation. The prophet was even with them inside that situation. He was smiling. When there was famine in Israel, you think Elisha was not in Israel? He was inside there. There was hunger until people were eating themselves. You think Elisha was eating human being also? He was feeding very well. Until the king of Israel now decided, I know where the solution is. The only thing is that he came the wrong way. No, this thing must change. I'm going to the house of Elisha. Elisha said, by this time, tomorrow, even in Ebanwe. Praise God. When you are not there, first month, 2 months, 3 months, on our smile, God is waiting for you. Hey, help me tell another person, stop waiting for God. God is waiting for you to move. That is the reason for this program. Did you think that God didn't see the woman of the issue of blood? But God was waiting for her to move. You thought that God didn't see the condition of the woman whose husband died in debt. He died in debt. The husband was even a prophet. Do you know you can be so close to the anointing and yet anointing will not profit you until you trigger it off? Let me show you something in that story. Chapter what? No, the story of the woman and the oil. Chapter 4. 2 Kings chapter 4. Now there cried a certain woman of the sons of the prophets unto Elisha, saying, thy servant, my husband, is dead. Your husband will not die in Jesus' name. Can you read the next thing with me? And thou knowest. Stop there. It is one thing to know the president. It's another thing for the president to know you. Most people now know Trump. Abi, if you see his picture in the social media, you will know. But for Trump to know you, that is his passing. He say, Angel, how are you? It's a different thing. The Elisha, the national prophet, the woman was addressing him. He said, thou knowest my husband. You know my husband. That is, the man enjoyed such closeness to the anointing. You know my husband, that when he was alive, he was a God-fearing man. Thy servant, my husband, is dead. And thou knowest thy servant did fear the Lord. And the creditor is come to take unto him my two sons to be born men. This man had the privilege of having personal relationship with Elisha. And he died in debt. The wife rose from the same family and turned the fortune of the family around through the same prophet. Omobai told a story I will never forget. You find it in his book, Kingly Anointing. He said his cousin was sick in Nigeria, and the friend of his cousin was sick in one of these West African countries. So the cousin of the friend of the cousin, I've forgotten the exact country, but when you open that book, you see it. Oh, where about cousin no more by? Sir, please, can I get your brother's phone number? I want him to pray for me. He said, oh, sure, with all pleasure. And he gave him the phone number. He called and he was able to get to Mumbai. It was many, many, many years ago when he had time. He said, please, this is what is happening to me. I wish to come and see you. He granted him audience. So he came, traveled to Nigeria. And Omobai prayed for him. His sickness was very bad. He has gone to several hospitals. A man who has had money to travel that distance, he had gone to several hospitals to no avail. Now, at the same time, the cousin of Omobai was also sick. That person that gave the phone number, he was also very sick. And he called Omobai and said, please, I need money to go to hospital. He requested for 40,000, and I think Omobai gave him 80,000. That was many, many years ago when money was money. Praise God. His cousin went to hospital and died. The one he prayed for recovered. His cousin saw him as his cousin. Just like the brothers of Jesus. He didn't see prophet that can change his story inside of Mumbai. He died in that sickness. And somebody flew from outside Nigeria and saw the prophet inside Omobai. Omobai prayed for him and he was healed. I won't forget that story. It keeps me humble that anytime I have privilege to connect to an anointing, I will not despise that privilege. That is why we travel all the way to Yoko to receive 5 minutes prayer. You need to know how we travel. He does counseling by 8. I mean by 12, he sees pastors. 12. If you are not able to enter by 12, you have to go back and come another Tuesday. Thank God by now, by the mercy of God, we can stay in the hotel room all alone together with him and without anybody else. And we are discussing for more than 30 minutes. But we didn't start that way. So we will leave by 5:30 to Yoko. Somebody will be driving us. 5:30 in the morning we have left. To be able to arrive there before 10 or 11. So that we will not miss the opportunity. And then we go loaded. Who is talking about 100,000? Loaded. Several Let me not shake the faith of some people. Praise God. Sometimes we have to pay into account because you can't go with such money. We pay part into account and go with teller. To receive 5 minutes prayer. 5 minutes. Ah, only 5 minutes. Jova asimo. Iyo bona ne no chiuzo ke ewezu gea. Ono do bona nke ne wuteha. Oba wela, oba wela, oba wela. 5 minutes. Baba napa. Praise God. When the road became so bad that we couldn't go in our private vehicle, sometimes I and this, my girlfriend, okay, she's not here now. Praise God. We will lodge in the hotel. We will move by Monday, 2 p.m. to arrive Uyo and lodge in the hotel. After seeing him, normally by the time he will finish, by the time we get there, a lot of people who we are living around are taking number 20, number 40. So a lot of the time it is by 3 p.m. or 3:30 or 2:04. And the last bus from Uyo direct to Oka leaves before 2 p.m. So we take a vehicle from Uyo to maybe Aba and sleep in the hotel again in Aba. How many hotels now? Two. And then to come back on Wednesday morning. How many days journey, sir? 3 days. To receive 5 minutes prayer. But it's working. The evidence is all over the place. Can you put your hands to Jesus? Anytime you have a program like this, that people have been praying, fasting, doing night vigil, praying in the daytime, gathering in the morning to pray for you so that your condition will change. Don't despise it. The man was so close to the anointing, but he never changed his life. You are a prophet. We grew up in this thing. Sons of the prophet. We were born in church. And they died in poverty. And the wife recognized the prophet inside the same man. And the fortune of the family changed. Everything tying you down, I command it broken now. It is broken now. It is broken now. I really thank God for my family members. Because contrary to my expectations, they really see the prophet of God in this little child. Praise God. That's why all of them are part of what we are doing. You saw them during the Thanksgiving, the one in America. He came here. Anytime he comes around, he comes for service. Praise God. And the great servant of God, you know, is here. My mother is here. My in-laws are here. Praise God. What is my counsel to you? Go with prophetic partnership. Before they set out on that journey, they said, man of God, please go with us. And he said, I will go. Verse 2, let us go, we pray thee, unto Jordan, and take thence every man a beam, and let us make a place there where we may dwell. And he said, go ye. He said, no, sir. Something remains, sir. He said, what is that? Verse 3, and one said, be content, I pray thee, and go with thy servants. And he answered, I will go. That was the deciding factor for somebody in that place. Unknown to them, there was a man bound by the spirit of smallness to the extent that others brought their own axe. He had to borrow his own because there was a power that vowed that he would remain small. He couldn't have the axe. ndị ọzọ ji nke ba nyanwa borolu nke ihe boro mụọ nwa si na ọ gara arise to greatness jekwuo nali anyị ike tunye na mmiri otie alas master it was borrowed I told you the story of a young man. My half brother told me that pathetic story. He has been pleading with his brother in America to send him money. Care will be no business. That was many years ago. And his brother was telling him, Kiano zitekwo, kiagada up, that I'm going to help you. Eventually, he sent him money in dollars. That my half-brother, the young man, Yele, Je Nabalogun, change ye the money. A change ye, it amounted to a little above 1 million naira. Okay, Jibido life. That my brother advised him to put it in one particular bank. Ebe yawana a bank. Yawana a zoo motor parts. Na Lagos. The man of God knows who I'm talking about. So the young man see mba neangwele bank now high interest rate. After that bank about Savannah Bank. He put the opened the account in Savannah Bank. Put the money there. 2 days later, Savannah Bank closed down. That is the same story of this man. Let us go and cut wood so that we can expand, so that we can enlarge. Others collected wood, their own acts. Himself, he didn't have the spirit of poverty, the spirit of smallness so much held him down that he didn't have anyike. And then he now borrowed. And he joined others to cut. He said, who are you? You make progress. Collected the thing from him. He said, water. Rise to your feet.
Join us every Sunday. We have 2 power-packed services. First service starts 7:30 a.m. in the morning. Second service starts 9:30 a.m. Every Wednesday we have midweek service, School of Success, and it starts 4:30 p.m. Every Saturday we have a non-denominational service. People come from different churches, pastors come from different denominations, and the time is 7:30 a.m. in the morning. As you come, remember that a miracle is waiting for you. The venue is Royal Priesthood Church Cathedral beside Public Borehole Umike by UBA Uwoji of Zik Avenue, Oka, Anambra State, Nigeria. You can follow us on Facebook, you can follow us on Instagram, you can follow us on Twitter handle and watch Pastor Wisdom Onyebuchi's messages live on YouTube. For more inquiries, you can call 081-4006-7698, or you can call 081-3585-4764, 081-3585-4764. Join us same time, same station next week. God bless you.